Hi, my name's Leslie. I'm the director of Genesis Wildlife Conservation Center and the sanctuary. We began in about 1983, and then it grew from there so that we're now a charity. We collect from the people who come here, donors. Some of it we get from foundations, but we rehab about 600 to 700 birds and animals every year. Most of them are released back to the wild, and some of them can be released to about their own environment. Because he's so small, he wouldn't really stand a chance out in the wild.
So you guys looking for someone to take him in? Or?
No, we keep him and use him for education. Yeah, you have to have permits to have any of the animals. And we have to have federal, state, USDA permits, everything. So. I know. That's why we keep them well padded. You know, all the cages are padded, so when they fall, they only fall to the bedding. That's Samsara. Sam I've had since 1998. Such beautiful birds. Sasha is now 6 months old. She came to us as a baby about 5 weeks old when the whole nest fell to the ground. Her brother did just fine and he's already been released. But the female, Sasha, on the x-ray, it shows the wing, the right wing just really shattered and not able to pin it. So that's why she stays with us. And we take her around to schools and we talk about their habitat and the need to preserve it. This black and white one down here, though, that has an interesting story because see how her wing droops? Mm-hmm. Well, that's only part of her injuries. When I had released her along with a bunch of other pigeons, and then when she came back, she was in the backyard, had like in the middle of February, and it was snow everywhere, and I looked out the back window, and it was just blood everywhere. And I ran out to see what it was, and it was this poor little pigeon, and she had come back to get cared, I guess, for, or at least it was a safe haven for her. So we treated her. She's blind in one eye. She had a lot of, her whole side was ripped off. The wing was broken. So I treated her back. She fell in love with the old fantail pigeon. And when the old fantail got sick, she would take care of him. I had him inside in a small cage. She would get up under his wing and walk him to the dinner dish. Her story is that when she was about 3 weeks old, some kids found her in the bushes, probably while the mom was moving them from one place to another. So she spent the next 9 weeks at the animal control, where she was placed in a cage next to dogs, and kids could come, everybody could come. So she didn't learn to fear any of us. Uh-huh. So that's why she's got to stay with us. I tried to release her a couple times, and it was a failure each time. This one over here is... This is Callie, Kalahari, and Callie was once a pet, but she's not a very good pet. So she's about 7 years old, and she's had a pretty bad life before. I got her from animal control in Ash, and she had been there 11 months, and they were not able to place her with anybody that had a USDA permit, and you have to have a USDA permit to keep these cats. Come on in. Just undone my. She was just spayed. So. Again, we use these in educational programs to show people that they really are very sweet animals. They're extremely intelligent, very curious animals. People think the only thing they're good for is just for shooting. You know, they're just supposed to be a sport animal, and they're not. Of course, they serve a lot of different purposes, but other than that, they have their own right to live, just because they are. God made all of us, and we all have a right to live. You can go to our website, which is genesiswildlife.org, and you can get an idea about our volunteer relationships. We have a lot of volunteers here. We have a lot of groups that come. Sometimes we can get 15 or 20 people. And of course, you put in 3 hours, that's an incredible amount of work that we can get done in just one day. So it's really nice when we get Cub Scouts or ASU volunteers. Matter of fact, we had the ETSU come, and they were the ones that built this whole deck behind me. They built the entire thing in one day, but we had about 20 big guys come here to do that.
As far as donations, just not monetarily, but you can also donate lumber.
You can donate time, you can donate equipment. We get a lot of people who just come with, they're building their homes, and they have a lot of leftover lumber, a lot of things like that. They can come and we can use all of that lumber. We can use everything. We get people who just bring in linens, which is extremely important to us. Some people will bring in some of the dog food and the sunflower seeds, bags of bird seed. All of these things can be donated to us.